A very good morning, students. So as you know that we have already started with our pollination, and we have finished with one type of pollination, that is pollination by wind. And pollination by wind is known as anemophily, right? So today we will talk about pollination by water. And when the pollination is by water, it is known as hydrophily. Right, this thing is known as pollination by water. So hydrophily, hydro word, this name is given for the water. So pollination, when we say by water, it can be of two types. One, that it takes place under the water, as well as few plants, they like pollinate on the surface of water. So our hydrophily, it is of two categories. And what are those two categories? One is under the water, that is for those plants which are submerged, which are present under the water. And second is on the surface of the water. So I'm taking here, as you can see on your screen, they are on the basis of that which category to plant follows. If it is under the water, it is known as hypohydrogamy, as well as it is also given the name hypohydrophily, right? It is also given the name, that is hypohydrophily, as well as those which happens on the surface of the water, it is also known as your epihydrophily. So hypohydrophily or hypohydrogamy, as well as epihydrophily. Two examples which are given in our NCERT also. Very, very important example, that is Zostera and Ceratophyllum. First type of hydrophily which I will talk about is, that is hypohydrophily, which will I talk about, that is hypohydrophily. And in hypohydrophily, two examples which I am going to talk about, that is Zostera and Ceratophyllum. Now I said this is type of pollination which takes place under the water. So which kind of plant then do you think these Zostera and Ceratophyllum, they will be? They are submerged plants, submerged in the water. So they are, first characteristic about these two Zostera and Ceratophyllum is they are submerged rooted plant. Right, first point is clear. Then the second point, you can say they are present at the bottom of the water body because they are submerged. So second point is that they are present at the bottom. Then third line, very given in your NCERT, that they have different kinds of, special kind of pollen grains. You can just mark it in your book also, that Zostera is a aquatic plant which has a longest needle-like pollen grains. And one major very special feature it has, that this is without exine. You know that it is the outermost covering of the pollen grain. So Zostera is a plant which has a very long needle-like pollen grains, long needle-like, and it does not have exine. So I said three points about these Zostera, about these plants, that they both are rooted, submerged, present at the bottom. And Zostera jo hai, it has a longest needle-like pollen grains. Actually, needle-like pollen grains are needle-like specially so that they can survive the water current, so that they can survive under the harsh flow of water, right? So if you draw this diagram, right, if you draw this diagram, so because they are submerged, they are present under the water, they are rooted plants, their male flower as well as female flowers, they grow in the groups, they grow in clusters. Zostera, they has a longest needle like leaves, narrow leaves, as well as longest pollen grains to minimize the resistant to provide resistant to the basically minimize the to water current, to survive from the harsh water currents. And male and female flowers, how do they grow? That is important because you have to draw the diagram in your exam. So here, as you can see, this is our male flower, right? This one is male flower, and here you can see this is female flower. They both grow in groups, they both grow in clusters. That is why I have written this point that they grow in the groups. Now male flower jo hai, what will it release? It will release pollen grains, and when it will release pollen grain, they are long, they are needle like. But that is why Zostera, this question is from your for your NEET also, that which kind of pollen grains they are present in Zostera. Needle like pollen grains, longest needle like pollen grains. Now these pollen grains, now imagine they are submerged, right? They are under the water. Male is growing in cluster, female is growing in cluster. If now pollens are released, if anything is lighter, what will it do in the water? If anything is lighter, it will start floating on water surface. If it is heavier, it will sink in the bottom. So pollens, these Zostera pollens, they have same specific gravity as water. Therefore, they remain inside the water only. Neither they float on the water nor they sink at the bottom. Now other flowers of Zostera, they are also growing in the water. So as water flows, as the moment the water is flowing, they come in contact with the female flower. And जरूरी नहीं है कि सेम प्लांट का हो, इट कैन बी अनदर फीमेल फ्लावर ऑल्सो. एंड द मोमेंट इट कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद दिस फीमेल, देयर विल बी द पोलन ग्रेन्स, दे विल स्टिक ऑन स्टिग्मा. द मोमेंट पोलन ग्रेन्स दे सिट ऑन स्टिग्मा, पॉलिनेशन विल हैपन, एंड आफ्टर पॉलिनेशन देयर विल बी fertilization. So this is the method of pollination in which kind of plants? Those plants which are submerged under the water, which are submerged in the water, or which are you can say deeply present in the water, right? And this type of pollination is known as hypohydrophily. Now second category is for those plants which prefer to pollinate on the surface of water, and this type of hydrophily is known as epihydrophily. And epihydrophily example we will take, that is Vallisneria. Important for your every type of MCQ. Every type of MCQ, this is important. That Vallisneria. Vallisneria is commonly known as eel grass also. We call it as a eel grass. Now, this is also a submerged plant. But here, one thing is very special, and this question was asked in a few years back in the NEET also, that Vallisneria is a dioecious or it is a monoecious plant. Bacha, Vallisneria is a dioecious plant. These terms should be clear to you, right? Monoecious and dioecious, right? Dioecious means when your male and female, their parts are separate. When male flower and female flowers, they are growing on separate, they are growing separately on separate plant. And monoecious means male and female flowers, they are on the same plant. That is called your monoecious. For animal, we use unisexual and bisexual. So vellicinaria is which kind of plant it is? It is a dioecious plant. Male and female plants, they are basically separate. Now, if you look at this diagram, the another very important feature about the vellicinaria is that here, as you can see, this is your male flower, right? Male flower, one is male flower and one is your female flower. Female flower has a very long stalk, and then they have stigma and your style, very long stigma and style. And a male plant or the male flowers, they grow in a group, and this group is known as spadix. We call it spadix, right? This group of male plant of vellicinaria, it is known as spadix, right? Am I clear to everyone that female flower alag grow karta hai, male flower alag grow karte hain, right? Male plant or female plant separate hote hain in the vellicinaria. It is a dioecious plant, right? So don't confuse with this. Don't get confused. It has a long, very long stalk like structure. It has a grows as a stigma and style in the female, but male it grows in a group which inflorescence bolte na, jab bunch mein koi cheez grow karti hai usko kya bolte ho aap, inflorescence. So inflorescence in the male plant of vellicinaria usko kya bolte hai, kis type ki inflorescence. One another objective question, which kind of inflorescence of vellicinaria you can see, that is spadix. It is known as spadix. Now after maturity, jab tak to ye grow kar rahe hain, they grow in us, if they remain in this spadix only, they remain in this inflorescence. The moment they get matured, after maturity, it is said that these male flowers, they start detaching from this group. And what is the group's name? Spadix. So they detach from this spadix, they move up and open, they reach to the surface. Basically they reach on the surface. Now once they reach on the surface, these male part, they have tepals. They have basically three tepals. So here in vellicinaria, as you know, as in class 11th, we study the perianth, basically outer part of the flower, which involves your calyx as well as corolla. So here vellicinaria, when the male flower, it get matured, it comes on water surface. It has a perianth. In perianth, it does not have as specific sepals and petals. It has three tepals. Like, so this is these three tepals, they are known as actually perianth when there is no differentiation in calyx and corolla. So we call it as a tepals. Here are our anthers, right? As you can see, these this is our anther part, lobes. So when female flower, now after maturity, female flower uncoiled ho jata hai. It is the fully coiled long stalk like structure, and the moment it get matured, this stalk or you can say this long tube like structure, it get uncoiled and it reach on the surface. The moment this female stalk reach on the surface, it exposes its stigma. Wo stigma uska bilkul surface ke upar nazar aata hai. So stigma is exposed on the surface. Anthers are there. So anther will release pollen grains. These pollen grains, they will fall on the stigma. So stigma of the female flower, they expose, the moment this long coil stalk like structure of the female, it become uncoiled and it reaches on the surface. It exposes its stigma. The moment isne apna stigma expose kar diya, now the pollen grains, they will sit on this stigma and the pollination happens and then fertilization happens. But the one question which goes in the mind, what happened after pollination or fertilization? This long, as you can see, this structure, this long coiled portion, this uncoiled portion, it again come back and again become coiled and come back to the original position. So this happens in the Vallisneria. Vallisneria follows which kind of pollination? That is epihydrophily. Epihydrophily is which kind of water pollination? In which there is a pollination on the surface of water. What is the inflorescence in Vallisneria? Spadix. What is so special about the female? They have a long coil stalk like structure, right? This stigma jo hai uska jo style hai, basically that style is very long and coiled, and the moment it becomes mature, this becomes uncoiled and reaches on the surface ke pe pahunch ke wo apna stigma expose kar deti hai. Now on this surface pollen grains, if the matured male flower is there, it will release its pollen grain on the stigma and the pollination will happens and female again come back to the normal position. So this, you can note down these two points about the hydrophily, right? And next we will talk about the other agencies of the pollination. Till then you can complete your notes from my videos till this point, that is the hydrophily. I will meet you with the another agents then.